Chapter 1, Part B, Briefs. Now we're going to talk about judicial systems in BC. So courts of original jurisdictions or trial courts. So how many courts are there? So there are four, right? Number one is small claim court. Is the lowest court in a BC. Lowest level trial, it's not trial, trial, right? So they decide cases up to $25,000 or less. You want to sue somebody for $25,000 or less, you can go to small claim court. It has a territorial restriction. Person being sued lives or carries out business there, right? For example, right? Local, you live here, you go to your local court, right? Cause of action arose in the territorial decision of the court can appeal to Supreme Court of BC. If something happened, right, you want to sue somebody, if you lose in small claim court, where can you go further? Supreme Court of BC. Then the second one, BC Supreme Court, is the highest level of trial court in BC. There's no limit here. No monetary or territorial restriction. So anybody in BC can do that, right? So basically, means you want to, you know, sue somebody for $1, you can sue for $1 too. There's no limit. And then appealing from small claim court does not automatically lead to a new trial. For example, you lose there, it's not automatic. If there is a wait in your case, then they take it, right? This court may allow a new trial, and if so, all evidence is reheard. Judge gives a decision. If you lose it here, then where do you go? You go to BC Court of Appeal. You go to BC Court of Appeal. BC Court of Appeal is the highest court in BC. It says it will review legal principle applied by trial judge. If trial judge made an error in applying those principle, this is maybe reverse we were talking about on top. BC Court of Appeal is the highest court in BC. Most cases this court will not rehear the evidence presented at the trial level. Most cases they want something new. If there's a wait in, it's up to them to take your case. So the judge uses the discretion, right? We look at the legal principle applied by the trial judge. If trial judge made an error in applying those principles, the decision may be reversed. Usually three judges, but could be five or seven judges that hear appeal, and majority decides the matter. So I'll highlight three, five or seven judges. If you lose there, where can you go to? Supreme Court of Canada. Supreme Court of Canada is the highest appellate court in Canada. Either party can try to appeal to this court. So still, again, it's up to them to take your case. This court can decide whether or not to hear your appeal. If they decide not to hear appeal, your BC Court of Appeal decision will stand. So here 3, 5, 7, or 9 judges hear the appeal if allowed, and no evidence is reheard. Again, same thing, they deal with legal issues. So majority decide. So basically in the exam question, what it comes is, they'll ask you, if you lose it here, where do you go? If you lose in small claim court, where do you go? If you lose it there, then BC Court of Appeal. If you lose it there, Supreme Court of Canada. If you lose it there, you know, I used to say to Bush, not to Obama, right? Or Harper. So, and the other one, it normally comes, so the question comes is about, it's up to them to rehear you, right? To hear your case, right? It's not automatic. Then you go to the next one. Yeah. And then we talk about other one is plaintiff and defendant, right? Judicial systems in BC. So who's a plaintiff? Plaintiff means a person who sue you, right?
Injured party.
Yeah. And defendant, a person who defends. You rear end somebody's car, right? So the person to whom you are rear-ended is a plaintiff and you are a defendant. Yeah. So cause of action arise. Cause of action means this guy called him something, right? And this guy now slap him, right? So what happened? Cause of action, right? Civil wrong is committed. Breach of contract or tort. So what do you do? Lawyer, plaintiff, and lawyer and defendant. So what do? You commence the action. So what do? When you start the action, you go writ of someone. So names injured party. He say, you know, this guy used, right, or slapped me, right? And now what happened? So it allows defendant to dispute claim. He say, you know, I slapped him because he said something to me, right? So allows defendant to dispute. First writ of summon, then appearance. Then what happened? Happened in the written pleadings. Basically, the defendant make a, give the detail of claim made in a writ, right? So who makes the claim? Plaintiff makes a claim, right? And then the defendant deny the claim, statement of defense. And then what happened then? Then case goes to discovery, right? Numerous written replies are entered to try to narrow the issues. Discovery is kind of mini trial, is it? Mini trial. Each party is examined under oath by the other party's lawyer. Documents are examined and most action are settled in a, there's no judge there, right? You and your lawyer and the defendant and defense lawyer, they present each other's case. If the defendant find the case is weak, they settle there, right? If the defendant find the case is not weak, so then you go for a trial. So trial, plaintiff must prove case, right? The person who is sued. Judges hear all evidence, listen to witness, and give decision at a later day. Then the judgment. So successful party awarded a judgment, right? Court course at court's discretion. Court course basically means it doesn't matter that you lose a case, that you have to pay the cost. It's the judge who decides. It's not always the losing party pays. So in the exam come always makes it wrong, right? Is a court course at court's discretion. So this line word will give you one mark. Okay. So what in the exam they ask you? They give four steps, right? So you arrange them in an order. They'll give you writ of summon, appearance, discovery, a statement of claim, and discovery. They'll give you like this. So discovery will be on top, you know, first, and you arrange it. You understand, right? So you need to remember the six steps. Number one is writ of a summon. Number two is, number two is appearance. Then the pleading. So in pleading, they may write the statement of claim, or they may write the statement of a defense in the exam, right? One of them is a part of that. And then fourth one is a discovery.
Sorry, number one is a proof of
someone. Then two is appearance.
Written is pleading?
No, appearance. Yeah, in the exam, I'm talking about how they ask you in the exam. They'll put the writ of someone, appearance, statement of claim, and discovery. Right? So how are you going to do it? Writ of someone is A, then appearance, then claim, then discovery. Right? So you don't lose a mark in the exam.